following is a presentation of CBS Sports.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Pat O'Brien, and while the country cools off, we remain hot here on the show. Today, we begin our coverage of the Riders Ladies Skating Championship, where we'll see the sizzling 1994 Olympic gold medalist Oksana Bayul, fiery Yuka Sato, the 1994 world champion, and heartwarming 1984 Olympic silver medalist, America's own Rosalind Sumners. And the thermometer sure to rise when we go from the hottest stars on the ice to the searing gridiron. And he's a leader of men who knows exactly where he is, exactly where he's going, and exactly what he's doing, almost all of the time.
I will be going to New York this weekend. John will have to tell me what I'm doing because you're the guy who got me into this thing. I'm going to go do something in New York with CBS. I don't know what it is. So.
Well, we know what it is. It's an appearance on the show. It's Notre Dame head coach Lou Holtz, and with his help, we'll have all the scores, highlights, and info on the college scene. Now, it is 4 p.m. Eastern time. Do you know where your mascot is? We're sure to get your goat here on the show. Welcome, everybody, to the show. Not to worry, animal lovers and Navy football fans. We have confirmed reports that Bill the Goat, numbers 26, 28, and 29, have been safely returned to their team. And while we're speaking in military terms, this year marks the 50th anniversary of the end of World War II. So on this Veterans Day, the show pays special tribute to our veterans, thousands of whom march maybe in your town here in New York City in the nation's parade, complete with jet flybys, a 21-gun salute to commemorate the day. From a parade in the city to a parade on ice, we'll leap to the land of a thousand lakes shortly for the Riders Ladies Skating Championships. And now we welcome the gridiron guru of South Bend, Notre Dame coach Lou Holtz, to the show. And coach, nice to have you here. Good to see you.
Thank you.
Nice to see you in good health. What's your headline on college football today?
Well, I think that you get this stage of the game, there are very, very few upsets. Some people play very, very close games, but very seldom will there be an upset this late.
Coach, you'll enjoy coaching other people's teams from this spot right here, okay?
I like this already.
Let's fire up this scoreboard on a snowy and blustery day. How good is Nebraska, Coach?
I think they probably ought to be playing on Sundays. Great defense, great quarterback, great offense. Great
at
coach.
Kansas today, 7-0 in the first quarter. Illinois and Ohio State, that game just underway, and Ohio State has already scored 7-0 in the first quarter there. Northwestern and Iowa, the final here, 31-20. Northwestern, a Cinderella story, no longer a Cinderella team, huh, Coach? 0 degrees at the wind chill there, and special teams played a big part today.
Well, they have all year. You're going to see Musso field a punt, which sort of caught Iowa by surprise, and he goes 60 yards with it, but they scored on defense. They did a variety of different ways. Great team.
Brian Musso, son of former Chicago Bear running back Johnny Musso, he goes all the way, and the final is 31-20. There. Florida State, North Carolina, surprised the score was as low as it was. 28-12 was the final. Bobby Bowden out there in the tough weather. First play from scrimmage to Warrick Dunn.
Well, Warrick Dunn is probably as good a back as there is in the country, and he scores a touchdown on this. The weather was absolutely deplorable. Bobby probably wouldn't play golf in that type of weather, but Florida State's for real.
Bobby, I think, would play golf in this type of weather, and Florida State is for real, and they come back, they win 28-12 there. Iowa State, Kansas State, 28-7 now in the third quarter. Matt Miller with two rushing and one passing touchdown. Missouri and Colorado, 14-0 now in the third quarter. How about this score, folks? Michigan over Purdue, 5-0 in just miserable weather out there in a big house at home, 35-mile-an-hour winds. Bad weather and turnovers were a factor here.
Well, in a game like this with the weather conditions, a kicking game and turnovers going to determine the outcome of the game. And here you're going to see Michigan recovers a fumble on Purdue's 3-yard line, which led to a field goal, and the safety is the only thing counting for the scores.
Tough break for Purdue, and the score was 5-0 there in that battle down there at Ann Arbor. Virginia and Maryland, 21-18, the final there. Virginia, a little bit of a roll, and he's done a great job, hasn't he?
Well, George Welch has done a great job everywhere he's been, Pat. They had a great win over Florida State, and then to come back and have a convincing win against Maryland, I know it was 21-18, but they were behind 11-0 early in the game.
21-18 there, and we saw a lot of bad weather today. What's your worst, rain, wind, snow?
I hate the wind. You know, you can have it be cold, you can have it be rain, but the wind affects the kicking game, it affects the passing game, it affects a lot of things, which is one reason Colorado is having a little bit difficult time with Missouri.
Coach, let's see how the folks out here, our Gigabyte gang, voted in the CBS Sports Worldwide Web College Football Fan Poll. Our staff, using only a number two pencil and some pickup sticks, has been hard at work tabulating your choices. Heading into this weekend, the Cornhuskers are number one, Ohio State is second, Florida State in third, in spite of their loss to Virginia last week. Florida and Northwestern are 4 and 5, while the Kansas schools round out the top 10. Where's Notre Dame? If you want to chat with Pat, vote in this week's poll, the Heisman Race, or tap into our other interactive offerings, check out our homepage on the web at www.cbs.com or speak to us directly. Our email address is sports@cbs.com. And Coach, where is Notre Dame in that poll?
Either the computer is not infallible, made a mistake, or else we don't have enough alums to know how to work a computer, so we're going to have to look into that.
Regis Philbin, come on, you got a computer somewhere. Later on, we'll talk more with Coach Holtz and update you on all the scores, video, and info from today's action on the Ford Taurus College Football Today. Now we continue with our fall figure skating coverage today from Minnesota. Let's join Verne Lundquist for the Riders Ladies Skating Championships.
Ladies figure skating combines so many elements. Concentration. Grace. Artistry. Today you'll see six ladies compete in the first round of the Riders Ladies Skating Championship. The competition features five Olympic medalists and world champions spanning the last 15 years. It's the best in ladies' professional figure skating. Stay tuned for Chapter 1. Heartland of Minnesota provides the backdrop for today's Riders Ladies Skating Championship. Welcome to the Mankato Civic Center in Mankato, Minnesota, a lovely town of 40,000, located about an hour and a half drive south of Minneapolis-St. Paul. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Verne Lundquist. Today, the premiere of a unique figure skating competition. This is the first in a series of events we'll bring you over the next several weeks. In the first two, here in Mankato and next in Chicago, we'll have two completely different fields of ladies competing. The top four in each city will advance to the finals in Boston a little later on. I'm joined, as always, by Scott Hamilton and Tracy Wilson. Scott, something else that's a little different today. Instead of the technical and artistic programs, we'll see two artistic programs.
Makes the whole event different. No technical competition means no 8 required elements, no mandatory deductions by the judges, and these skaters are allowed to deliver what they do best. Now, I've always said the difference between a good and a great skater is that the great skater will incorporate their personality and who they are through their performance. So with two artistic performances, they get to do only strengths, no weaknesses, and a great field of ladies. Four world champions competing, led by 1994 world champion Yuka Sato, skating really well. And she's up against some pretty stiff competition. The 1993 world champion and Olympic gold medalist in 1994, Oksana Bayul, both beautiful skaters. It's going to be a great competition.
Well, the top four out of the six ladies will advance to Boston. We also have a pairs event here, and we will determine a winner, Tracy. Mm-hmm. And like the ladies, we've got a wide diversity of style.
Well, there's a little bit of everything in the pairs event, Verne. Underhill and Martini really play on emotion, on the emotion between each other. And that draws in the audience and the judges, and they are captivating. Huff and Ledre, they're a little bit more upbeat and playful. They're a delightful team to watch. Then there's Hartshorn and Swiding, and they've only ever skated together as professionals. They are show skaters, and they bring with them all the tricks and the costumes to deliver a really dramatic performance. And then rounding out the pairs event, Urbanski and Marvel. They have huge tricks. They're an exciting and dynamic team. And this mix of styles is really going to make for an entertaining pairs event.
Once again, the qualifying competitions are being held in Mankato and in Chicago. The top four finishers from each site will advance to the final. The total points from the qualifying events will determine the seating at the final, and that final will be held in Boston, Massachusetts. Now, the rules for this event: two artistic programs by each competitor. There are five judges scoring on a 6.0 basis, and the scores for each program will be added to determine the total points. Our first event this afternoon, a pairs competition, and the first competitors on the ice The 88 Canadian champions, they've been professionals for the last 3 years. Christine Huff and Doug LeDray skating to the music of Sade. Is it a crime?
Toured with Doug and Tuffy for the last 3 years since they've turned professional, and what they've gained in those 3 years is a maturity and a confidence they didn't have as amateur competitors, and they're so versatile artistically. The performer, Doug's the strong, silent type.
Those of you who don't know Huff and LeDray, Christine Huff's nickname, and we all know her by that, is Tuffy. That's a testimony to her fearlessness on the ice.
And you need to be fearless for this next move. A release element, a throw, triple sow cow. He'll throw her in the air. That's beautiful.